So in today's lesson, we're going to learn to draw the genes. So on your course documents, you can see the handout with the genes, front and back, as well as the diagram, which we're going to follow to set the points. And also at the bottom, you can see where you can find a pencil tool. And you can also see object path, offset path function, which we're going to use to create the pocket. So let's begin. First, I'm going to open a new file in Illustrator. So you're going to go to File, New. You're going to click on Print. You're going to select letter size, and then you're going to click Create. Now you should have your layers visible. If not, you have to go to Window, Layers to display the layers palette. So first, I'm going to go to File, Place, to place my Judy. So you go to File, Place, you click on the Judy JPEG once, you turn on the button that says Template, and you click on Place once, and the Judy is ready to go. You are now in your layer one. So this layer I'm going to rename as Genes. The layer at the bottom is going to be renamed as Judy. So you double click on the layer name so you can rename it as Judy. And with the Judy layer locked, I'm going to select the layer on top, which is the genes layer. And now I can begin drawing the genes in the currently selected layer. So first of all, I'm going to select no fill. So always no fill, black stroke, and 1 point for line thickness. So this is a low waist jeans. So it's going to start somewhere at this level. So this is where I'm going to put my first point at the low waist area at the side seam. So point number one is a corner point. So I will just click once to create my first corner point. The second point will be at her hip level. So I'm going to click and drag going down, angling the handle slightly in order to get a nice curve preview. And when I'm happy, I will let go. So this is my curved point. So you, again, click and drag going down in order to create the curved point. The rest of the points are going to be corner points. So I'm going to click to create a corner point at the bottom, click to create another corner at the bottom for the hemline. And I will then click once in the middle of the center front line to create my last point. I'm going to press Command and click away in order to deselect the line. Now I can review my points and see if I need to move any of the points or if I need to move the directional handles in order to get a better curve. So far I'm pretty happy, but I think I will just maybe move this point a little bit more in. And I might also just drag the handle up a little bit to get a bit of a softer curve. So if I look at it now, I'm happy with it. Again, if you're not happy with your drawing, you don't have to redraw it. Instead, you can use the white arrow and move your points or move the directional handles in order to fix your lines. Next, I'm going to reflect this to the other side. So this is the same as before. You're going to use the black arrow, click and drag to select this line. You're then going to make sure that you have your reflect tool torn out. So the reflect tool, again, you're going to find under the rotate. So I'm going to just tear off my rotate so that I can see the reflect. And now I can reflect this piece. So first you're going to select it with a black arrow. You're going to click once on the reflect tool. You're going to press Alt Option key down, and you're going to click on your center front line of the Judy with Alt Option key pressed down. At that time, the reflect dialog box will come up. You just have to make sure that vertical is turned on, and then you have to click on the copy. Now you can zoom in and see if that worked. It's pretty good. You may want to just move over your points to just meet in the middle. You don't have to join them. It's not really necessary because we're going to use light paint to color the drawing in. But you just want to make sure that the lines are right next to each other, like that. Next, we are going to now create the waistband. So we're going to use the white arrow and then click and drag a marquee selection box with the white arrow around the top two points. And then we're going to hit Command J to join those two points. Then I'm going to use the reshape tool. So remember, the reshape tool can be found under the scale tool. So I'm going to tear off this menu as well. And then this is the reshape tool that I need to curve my waistband. So step one, you're going to use the white arrow to click on the line. Step two, you're going to click on the reshape tool, and then you're going to click and drag going up a little bit to reshape the back of the pants waistband going up. So again, I have used the reshape tool to curve my line going up a little bit. Next, I'm going to work on the waistband. So I'm going to first use the line segment tool to create a straight line going across. So I will click and drag with the line segment tool going across, but then I will press shift to constrain the handle to constrain the line to remain straight. So as I use the line segment tool, I press shift to make the line straight. Then I'm going to select the line with the white arrow, and then I will click once on the reshape tool. Then I will click and drag going down with the reshape tool, which will curve my line. Once I'm happy with the preview, I will let go, release my mouse, and I will now have the line completed. Next, I'm going to copy this waistband so that I will have the bottom waistband done using the copy. So I will select the black arrow. I'm going to go to Command C to copy, Command F to paste in front, and then I will use the arrow key on my keyboard to move the line down. I don't even have to select the line because it already was selected. But in case if it's not selected, you would just select it with a black arrow, and then you would use the arrow key on your keyboard to make the line go down. So this looks good to me in terms of proportion. So I can just use Alt Option key and then press it down, keep it pressed down, and then drag in the corner to stretch out the line. Now, once you've done with that, it'll look a little bit uneven, so I suggest that you use the white arrow, that you select the point in the middle, and then use the arrow key on your keyboard to make that point go down a little bit. So I clicked three times to make the point go down, and now the waistband looks a bit more parallel than it did before. Next, I'm going to create the top stitching that I need on top and the bottom of my waistband. So to do that, I'm going to use the shortcut that we have learned last time, which is Alt Option key. So if I use Alt Option key, if I press it down, I can click with the black arrow, and that's going to duplicate my line. So I keep my mouse pressed, and once I have moved my line down far enough, I let go. So that will create a copy for me. So now I have to turn this copy into a top stitching line. So as you know from before, you need to go to Window Stroke to display the stroke palette. And then in the stroke palette, you're going to select 0.5 line thickness, dashed line, and then I'm going to select two for dash and one for gap. So that's going to give me a nice top stitching. If you zoom in a lot, you can then move this line up or down in case if you're not happy where it is. So I'm going to put it here. This seems good. Now for the bottom line, I'm going to use exactly the same technique. The other thing that you could do is you could go to, you could use the black arrow, select your line, and then go to Command C, Command F. That'll copy a line on top, and then you can move it up using the arrow key. So if you don't like using Alt-Option key to duplicate your line, you can just use Edit, Copy, Edit, Paste in front instead. So that would give you the same result. Okay, so I've done that. And now I can just move in, zoom in, and then move the line down a little bit more like that. So when you do this, I would recommend zooming in a lot because then a computer will be more sensitive to tiny little movements of your line. So now this line I have created using Alt Option key and dragging to duplicate the line. Whereas this dashed line I have created by copying and pasting in front. So you can use either technique. I will now copy this line to create my top stitching. So using the white arrow, I'm going to select this point in the middle. I will go to Command C, Command F, and then I'm going to move the line down a little bit. And then I will use the eyedropper tool to copy the dashed line property. And finally, I can just move this line up closer to the edge. But I will zoom in quite a bit first in order to be more precise as I do that. So I will move it up. You can press Shift in order to make sure that it doesn't move left or right. And then you can move it with the black arrow. So now I think I'm good with this part. Next, I'm going to create a center front line using a solid black 1-point line. So I'm going to click and drag going up all the way up through the waistband. And here's my solid line. I will just make sure that it's placed in the middle. So using the black arrow, I will just move it in the middle like that. So next, I'm going to create my pockets. So for the pockets, I'm going to use the line segment tool and I will click and drag going down for the desired amount of pocket depth. Then I will switch to reshape tool and then I will click and drag on top of the line in order to curve it. Before you duplicate your top stitching, you want to make sure that you're happy with this line. Once you're happy with this line, then you can duplicate it in order to do top stitching. I'm just going to zoom in a little bit more so that I will be better able to put this line in the middle. So here we go. Now this line is a bit more in the middle, so this is fine. Good. So now I'm going to create top stitching on my pocket. So to do that, I'm going to use the black arrow, select my line, press Alt Option key, and then drag away a little bit, and then turn this line into 0.5 dashed 2x2 line. Sorry, 2x1 line. So this is my line. I feel like I should just move it away a little bit more. But again, when you do this, the best thing is to like really, really zoom in so that you can have better control. And you will also probably have to move the points around a little bit as well in order to be more precise with the line placement. So I might just want to move this point over a little bit. And now I'm happy with the placement. Once you're done with this, then you can now duplicate this line. So to duplicate this line, I'm going to again press the Alt Option key and then click and drag to move it over. Make sure that it's parallel. Now what might be easier is to just simply use the pen tool and lengthen this line. So I'm just going to zoom in here. And then using the pen tool, I'm going to connect and continue this line over to the side seam a little bit. And I'll do the same on top. So using the pen tool, I'm connecting and then continuing this line all the way to the top. So now I'm done with the pocket. I can now group the pocket and the top stitching together. So using the black arrow, I'm just going to click on top of these three lines, click and drag to select them, and then I will hit Command G, which will group them. At this time, now you can duplicate and place the other pocket across. So I will select the pocket in the top stitching with the black arrow. I will click once on the reflect tool. I will press Alt Option key, click on the center line. I will then get the dialog box, select vertical, and I will click on the copy. So now I have the same pocket on the other side. If you need to move it over a tiny bit, you can. So I'm going to zoom in and just move it over a tiny bit. So there we go. Finally, I'm going to create a button and the buttonhole, which will be the same as what we did for the skirt. So for the button, I'm going to use the ellipse tool with white fill, and I'm going to press shift as I draw in order to get a perfect circle. I'm going to change the line to 0.5 and make sure it's filled with white. Then I'm going to draw a little rectangle, very skinny rectangle, again using 0.5 as my stroke. And then I will align them using smart guides. So now the buttonhole is centered with a button, and now I just have to select the button, go to right click, arrange, bring to front, and then now I can group them together. So now you just have to make sure that you put it in the middle of your waistband. Next, I'm going to work on my fly. So the fly is a little bit hard because it's got double needle top stitching. So first of all, I'm going to preset my line to be 0.5 dashed 2x1. So this will allow me to create my first top stitching line, which, if you look closely, goes all the way down to the crotch seam. So with the line segment tool selected, I'm going to click and drag going down, press shift, and then let go. So this is my first top stitching line. My second top stitching line will go a little bit further away, the same distance as on your pocket. So I will click and drag going up, I will press shift to make it straight, and then I will stop. Then for this little top stitching to go across, I'm just simply going to use a line segment tool. So from here to here, I will use the line segment tool to create a line going across. You are now going to use the pencil tool. So the pencil tool is located under the shaper tool. So the second tool from top is the pencil tool. So I'm going to use the pencil tool set to 0.5 and solid line, not dashed. I'm just going to draw a line freehand going across. So this will indicate that little fold that happens when you have folded the pants flat on the floor like this. This is what you would see. So now I'm actually going to change, just make that line using one point. And then again, I have used the pencil tool to create this freehand line going across. Next, I'm going to draw the fly. The fly will be the same as what we did on the skirt last week, but it's going to be copied twice for the double top stitching look. So I'm going to first click once to set a first corner point. Then I will press shift. Then I will click again to set my second corner point. And then I will click and drag across here in order to create a curve. So here we go. I have a curve happening, and then I can release. And now I can change this to be 0.5-2x2. Again, you can use the eyedropper tool if you prefer. I'm happy with this, but I would like this point to go a little bit higher. So I'm going to select this point, and I will use the arrow key to make it go up a little bit. So now I have a bit of a nicer shape. Next, I have to duplicate this line of my top stitching. Before I do, I'll just squish this in a little bit more. Now I'm going to duplicate it by pressing Alt Option key down and then dragging over the specific amount that I need. And then I can use the bounding box to sort of just stretch this down a little bit more. And now I can just use my white arrow, sorry, to move the points. So there we go. I have completed the fly. Again, you're going to be able to use the white arrow and the directional handles in order to fix the look of your line. So that's it for the front view. The only thing I'm missing now are my belt loops. So for the belt loops, I'm going to zoom in as much as I can here into the waistband. I'm going to draw a rectangle using 1 point line, and it's going to be solid and filled with white. So I will select white fill and click and drag to create a solid belt loop. The reason why it's filled with white is so that the top stitching doesn't show through. So there we go. Before I rotate it, I'm just going to add top stitching lines and then group them together with the belt loop. So to do that, I'm just going to preset my line to be 0.5-2x1, and using the line segment tool, I will click and drag with the shift on each side in order to create top stitching. So you click and drag with the shift and the line segment tool to create top stitching on each side. And then I will use the black arrow to click and drag across the belt loop and the top stitching. And then I will hit Command G to group them. After they're grouped, then you can just angle them a little bit and also make sure that they are in the correct position. So here we are. This will be the correct position. And now I'm able to just duplicate this belt loop to the other side. So I'm going to select the belt loop. I will click on the reflect tool. I will click on the center line with the Alt Option key pressed down. The reflect box comes up where you have to turn on the vertical and copy in order to complete the other side belt loop. The final touch we need here is the top stitching, which you can see on the front inseam. So to do that, I'm just going to use 2 corner points. So I will first zoom out and use the pen tool in order to put my first corner point here. Then I'm going to scroll all the way down to the bottom in order to be able to put my second point. So I can actually maybe just zoom out in order to move faster. And I'm switching to the hand tool using my spacebar. Once I let go of the spacebar, I'm going to go back to my pen tool, as you know by now. So now I will click here in order to complete the top stitching. So now I can have a look and see if it's good. I think I just need to move it in a little bit at the bottom. So I can do that simply by using the white arrow and then moving the point over just a tiny bit like that. And now we'll do the same thing on the other leg. So first you're going to start on top and click to set your first corner point there. Then you're going to go to the bottom and you are going to put a corner point at the bottom. So you can again just move to the bottom, click once, and here is my inseam top stitching completed. Now I'm done with the front view, so what I can do is just select all of this with a black arrow and then hit Command G or Control G to group it. Now to create back view, I'm going to use Alt Option, press it down, and then with the Alt Option pressed down, I'm clicking and dragging with the black arrow in order to duplicate the front. So this will now serve as my back. So before I can begin, I'm just going to ungroup all of this so that I can then delete what I don't need. So I don't need the pockets. I don't really need the fly. I don't need the other pockets. I don't need the top stitching on the inside of the leg. I don't need the crotch line. I do need the 2 belt loops, so I'm just going to move them up. I don't need the button, so I can delete that. And I'm also going to delete the tiny little line that I drew going across. And I'm going to now also delete this line. So I don't really need this line. So I can use the black arrow to select these two lines and get rid of them. I can also temporarily use the white arrow to select these two points on top and then use the arrow key on my keyboard to make them go down like this. And now I just have to select the bottom two points, sorry, the middle points of this line and this line. So I can use the white arrow, click and drag around them to select them. Then these two points get selected. And now I can use the arrow key on my keyboard to move them up like that. So now I can just zoom out and see if I'm happy with the waistband width. I think I need to make the waistband perhaps just a little bit wider. So I'm going to select the waistband bottom with the top stitching using the black arrow. And then I'll move them down just a little bit. And then I will press Alt Option key and then stretch them out a bit using the bounding box. So now I'm more happy with the width of the waistband. And I can now move down one of these belt loops. And then I will reflect it. Next, we're going to do a little fold in the crotch area. So again, we're going to use pencil for that. It's going to be set to one point solid line, and then you're just going to freehand draw a little fold line at the back. And then we're going to extend all these lines all the way up. So I'm going to use the white arrow and the arrow key on my keyboard to make these lines go up. And then this point I will select with the white arrow and then use the arrow key on my keyboard to make it go up. And the same with this. So I will select this point and then make it go all the way up. And then I'm done with the back crotch seam. So then I have to work on the pockets and then reflect the belt loop and then we're done. So for the pocket, I would first start with a rectangle using one point solid line. So one point solid line is the preset. And it's going to have no fills. So use the rectangle, click and drag, and refer to the handout in order to get a nice proportion for your pocket. So I would say this is good. The next thing you have to do is add a point in the middle of the bottom pocket. So I'm going to be using Add Anchor Point Tool and Smart Guides so that I can see where the middle is. So this is the middle. So following the Smart Guide, I'm going to put the point here. So add one point right here, and there it is. So next, I'm going to use the white arrow to select that point and then drag it down. So that's gonna give you that nice shape on your jeans pocket. And next, I'm going to do my top stitching. Let me just see if I got the proportion right before I do top stitching. So again, you should check your proportion before you do top stitching. I think I'm gonna just maybe make my pocket just a little bit wider like that. And now I can start working on the top stitching. So for my top stitching, I'm going to use a new function. It's called offset path. So what you do is you select your pocket with the black arrow. Then you go to object, path, offset path. You're going to go minus one. And then you're going to click on preview. And then you're going to say OK. Now this inner line will be changed to 0.5 dashed. There we go. And now I can just cut this line in the middle in order to delete this portion of the line and this portion of the line. So I'm just going to zoom in here a bit more. I'm going to use the scissors, which can be found under the eraser. I'm going to click once in the middle. So this will cut this line. So if I select this point and hit delete, it'll delete that portion. And now if I select this point and if I hit delete, it'll get rid of that portion. Next thing I'm going to do is copy this. So Control C, Control F. And then I can just simply squish it in using the bounding box. And then I can just assess to see if I like the top stitching. It should be the same distance as the top stitching on the back crotch. I will also just make sure that my lines are going all the way up. So I will take this point and make it go up. I will take this point and make it go up, and the same on the other side. And finally, I just need to do the top stitching in the middle, which I can do by creating a straight line first. I can then add a point in the middle. So here's the middle. And then all I have to do is move this point down using the white arrow and the keys and the down key on my keyboard, the arrow key on my keyboard. Now I can group this together. So click and drag around it, hit Control G, and then you can now click on Reflect, click on the central line with the Alt option pressed, and then click on Copy. The same thing will be done with the belt loop. So select your belt loop. You will then click on Reflect, press Alt option, click on the center line, and then turn on Vertical and click on Copy. So this is it for the back view. I've noticed that we forgot to add the little rivets in the front. So I'm going to just zoom in here and I will create a rivet using ellipse tool. So press shift and create a little solid 0.5 white filled rivet like that. And then you can just copy and paste this on the other side in the corner. So I really should have done that earlier so I could have grouped it together. So that's fine, you can still do it. So just move it to the other side and now you can group all the front pieces together. So what I have now is grouped front, grouped back. Actually, I didn't group the back yet. So let's group the back. So I will use the black arrow, click and drag around all of the back pieces, and then I will hit Command G to group it. Now I can create my live paint. Okay, so now that you have your front and back finished, we're going to copy the pieces and create a new layer for live paint. So using the black arrow, I'm going to click and drag around the front and back to create a selection marquee, and then I will go to Edit Copy. I will now create a new layer by clicking on the New Layer button. I will rename it as Live Paint, and I'm going to go to Edit Paste to paste the front and back here. I will turn off the visibility of the jeans layer, and I will lock it, and then I will make sure that my Live Paint layer is active. So now I'm going to show you how to do live paint. So step number one, you're going to use the black arrow, click and drag a marquee around the front, and then go to Object Live Paint Make. The bounding box will change, which indicates that this is now a live paint group. I will do the same in the back. So use the black arrow, click and drag around all of the pieces of the back, and then you go to Object Live Paint Make, and then the back view turns into a live paint group. So next I can use the live paint bucket to add color. So I will go to Window Swatches to display my color swatches, which you can see here now, and then I will click on the live paint bucket. So remember that the live paint bucket is under the Shape Builder tool. So I will click once on the Live Paint bucket, then I will select the navy color, and then I can click to add color to all of the sections. It's actually faster if you just click and drag across. The computer will pick up all the little sections that you dragged across, and it'll be faster for you to highlight and color in all these sections. So here, you might have to even zoom in if you miss any of the parts, but if you click and drag, it's certainly going to be a lot faster. So using the Live Paint bucket, I'm clicking and dragging across to quickly add all the navy fill to all of the tiny little sections, and then you're done with that. The second thing we're going to do now is make all of our black lines light gray. So you're going to use the black arrow, select the entire jeans, and then select one of these light gray lines. The medium gray is usually good. So this way your seams will stand out better because the fill is so dark. So here we go. And now next, we're going to turn all of our top stitching lines into an orange stroke. So I'm going to use the white arrow. I'm going to select this top stitching line here, and then I will click here to bring the stroke box forward, and then I will select orange. So now I have orange stroke for this line. Now you could do the same thing for all of the other ones, but instead of doing one by one, I can just use the eyedropper tool. So to do that, you're going to use the white arrow, click on the top stitching lines you wish to select, press shift to select more than one. So white arrow, shift, and then I'm clicking on the top stitching line. So once you have selected all the top stitching lines you wish to include, then you can click on the original orange line using the eyedropper tool. So I will click on the eyedropper tool and then click once on the original orange line, and then I have changed the lines that were selected into orange. Don't worry if you miss any of the color, you can just use the paint bucket and then bring that color back in like that. And so now just double check to make sure that you didn't miss any of the original lines, which still need to be turned orange. So I have missed here and here. So I'm going to use the white arrow, select this line, press shift, also select this and this. So now with the stroke forward, I can click on orange, or I can again use the eyedropper tool instead. So that's how you're going to color your jeans. And again, they're going to have gray seam lines, orange top stitching, and navy fill. So that's it for your tutorial.